Dear chess friends, this is MVP bringing you the 10th part of my international chess course on the Kerken defense. And now we will talk about the plan of attack with the 6th move knight f3. And the topic of this part would be the endgame variation. So e4, c6. d4, d5, e takes d5, c takes d5, c4, knight f6, knight c3. Let's briefly talk about this position. Black has to choose what move, g6, e6, or knight c6 they can play. But I have chosen the knight c6 variation because it is the most solid from this three systems. So let's talk about knight f3, bishop g4. Black has developed the poorly placed bishop from c8 to g4, and the idea is to just play e6. C takes d5, knight takes d5, queen b3. Of course, white has an alternative on the 6, 7, and 8 move. We will talk about the alternatives in the chapter 14. Bishop takes f3, g takes f3, and the most solid continuation is e6. Of course, black can play knight b6, but nowadays they have black has some troubles here. So e6, the most solid continuation. Queen takes b7, knight takes d4, bishop b5, knight b5, and of course here white should try queen c6, because queen b5 is just a tempo for black. After queen d7, queen d7, king d7, knight d5, takes d5, bishop e3, bishop b4, king e2, rook ac8, rook ac1, and a6. Black has no weaknesses, and black has slight advantage. So queen c6, king e7, and here knight b5 isn't such a great idea due to rook b8, castles. Queen d7, knight e4. White doesn't want to exchange the queens, but rook c8 anyway. Queen a6, and here black has a novelty, knight b4. The white's only move is queen b5, but queen b5, knight b5, a6. Black has a better pawn structure, so black has a slight advantage here. But queen b5 is just automatically played, and queen d7. Here white can try to play queen a5, but even stronger masters played in such a manner. But black just plays knight takes c3, and after the exchange of the knight, they play f6 and king f7. B takes f6, for example, f6, castles, king f7, queen a6, bishop c5, with a big advantage for black, and Nishuk Driev Yalta, 1995. And if queen c3, then f6, bishop e3, king f7, castles, bishop 7, Zeitlin against Garry Kasparov, 1978, so here black has an advantage. And the other white's option is queen e2. It has a slight advantage on if we compare it with queen e5 move, because white can make a draw after knight c3, b takes c3, f6, castles, king f7. And here rook d1 is a dubious move. It was played in a game. Queen c6, queen e4, f takes e4, Bishop c5, rook d7, and king g6. Just better position for black. Lanka Vavra, Germany 2001, because white has a weak c3 pawn. But f4 is an option, queen c6, rook e1, bishop c5, and f5. Of course, black can play rook e8, but if rook he8, then f takes e6, rook takes e6, queen h5, king g8, rook e6, queen e6, queen c5, and just a perpetual check for black. It was played in the game by De Itkes in 2004. So these options are quite possible because white are not white is not losing, but knight d5 is automatically played here. Queen d5, and in the next chapter we will talk about bishop g5. Now it's queen d5, it takes d5. So here white has some options. The 16th move for castle is a variation, and bishop b3 is a b variation. The other moves are not such great. Let's start with bishop d2, king e6, bishop c3, and just bishop c5. If white takes on g7, then black moves the rook to g2 and just take on f2. Narciso against Mastavasilis 2006. The position is more or less equal, but in the practical game, black won the game because black has an open g file and the passed pawn on d. But here white can also try bishop f4, and here black can of course play king e6, but black tries king d7 with the idea castles long, and king c6 black protects the defined pawn, and black has no problems at all. For example, if rook d3 and bishop d6, bishop e3 and bishop f5, and this pen of variation, e5 is the best square for black, and if they can place a bishop here, they should try do it. King b1, rook hd8, rook c1, king d6, f4, bishop f6, rook c5, king e6, so with an equal position, and he shook hand, king, Polyanitsa Zdroy, 1999. And if king b1, then bishop d6, of course, rook d4, bishop f4, rook f4, f6 is just an equal position, Rectis Husman, Tel Aviv 1996. And if bishop e3, then just rook hb8, because black is bringing the rook on b5, rook d3, rook b5, rook c1, king d7, black protected the d5 pawn, and it is an equal position. So let's go back to the 16th move here. White can play the move a16, castles short. Black should play king e6. Black just protects the d5 pawn, and the idea is just develop the bishop to d6 or b4. White can try bishop e3, then black should play bishop b4, a3, bishop a5, before bishop b6, rook fe1, and the easiest move is just to play king f5, and if rook ad1, then rook hg8, and the position is equal. White can play rook e1, it is more ambitious continuation, king f5. And the most played move is rook d1, but I think this is not the best move. The better option is bishop e3, because black now should sacrifice a pawn, bishop b4, rook e d1, and of course rook hd8 is not so great, because rook ac1, and white just controls the c-file, but king a6, rook ac1, and rook hc8, rook c8, rook c8, a3. It is a main game. I played it in a rapid, and my opponent thought that I blundered a pawn, but it was a sacrifice of the pawn. Bishop d6, bishop a7, and bishop e5 was compensation. I think that rook d2 is a bad move due to rook c1, king g2, rook a1, bishop d4, and f6. White has an extra pawn, but black just wants to play rook a2 and bishop d4, so I think that my opponent played a good move. Bishop d4 immediately, bishop d4, rook d4, rook c1, king g2, king a5, rook d2, and d4. Black d4 pawn is too strong, rook e2, king d5, and the game was drawn. Some moves later, so white has an extra pawn, but I think that the position is equal. But white often plays rook d1 here, and black has an option of playing rook d8, because black just brings the rook to d7. Bishop e3, rook d7, and I think that here already black can fight for an advantage. For example, rook d4, bishop c5, rook f4, king e5, rook c1, and bishop b6 just playing for a win. Bishop e3, it's just an equal position. Rook h4, d4, rook e4, king f5, rook f4, king g6, rook g4, king f6, rook f4, king e7, rook e4, and king d8, so it is no perpetual check for white, and the d-pawn is very dangerous now. In the game it was played bishop d2, rook d5, a4, king d7, rook c1, bishop c5, rook e5, rook e5, rook e5, and king d6. Nielsen against Filipov, 1996, black had an advantage. But if rook ac1, bringing rook to c5, black just plays bishop e7, black is bringing the bishop to f6. Rook c4 is an interesting move. Bishop f6, if rook f4, then king e6, and if rook c5, then rook hd8, b3, bishop f5, rook e5, novelty, because bishop d4 is not such a great move. Rook b8, rook a5, rook b7, h3, f6, with the slight advantage for black in the game Wells against Adarian, Germany, 1989. But rook a5 is an option, because black should sacrifice the pawn. Bishop c3, rook a7, d4, rook d7, rook d7, and we saw already such position. Black has a decent compensation for the sacrifice pawn, so I think that rook c4 leads to the equal endgame, and rook d4 is not so great continuation that was played in the game of higher rated players, g5, rook a4, bishop f6, b4. White could try b3, but d4, rook c5, king g6, bishop d2, rook e8, king f1, and here black should make a novelty, d3, rook e4, rook e6, and, due to the past d3 pawn, white should play carefully because black has slight advantage. And if rook a7, then I just change in the pawns, and black has a d5 pawn that is more dangerous than the a2 pawn. And if b4, then d4, rook a5, king g6, bishop d2, rook e8, king f1. It was a game of Adams against Dreyev, weekend the 2002, and here black just should try rook e6, with the idea of a6, and black has slight advantage here. So let's move to the continuation. B, bishop e3. Here black must play king e6, so then the black player wants to play bishop b4. Castle's long. Castle shot was already analyzed in the Regine. If king e2, then white now has no rook e1 ideas, and black can easily develop the bishop to e5, bishop d6, rook c1, rook hc8, h3, bishop f5 is a slight advantage for black. If rook g1, then black also should try bishop d6, rook g7, bishop e5, rook g4, bishop b2, rook b1, rook hb8, king f1. It was a game of grandmasters Rogers against Adams, won in 1988. Here black should try to make a novelty, bishop c3, rook c1, rook c8, rook h4, bishop f6. Changing rooks, rook h6, king f5, rook h5, king e6, and the game is more or less drawish. If rook c1, then black should try bishop b4, king e2, and rook hc8, because white now can't take the a7 pawn. For example, king d3, a6, if bishop d4, then f6, h3, bishop d6, rook h1, g6, b3 is a dubious move, of course, bishop a3, rook c1, king f5 is advantage for black. In the other game it was played a3, bishop d6, rook h1, king f5, h3, bishop e5, bishop d4, f6, with an equal position. But the main continuation is castle's long, and here black must play bishop b4, otherwise rook he1, and black just a pawn down. And here white has some options. The first one is a3, but here black just plays rook hc8, king b1, bishop c5, rook he1, bishop e3, f takes e3. It's an important moment. In the next chapter we will see that after rook e3, king d6, in this position the pawn would be on f6, and the e6 square would be weak. And here it's not, so black has no problems. Rook d3, rook c5, b4, otherwise black just plays rook e8, rook e2. Rook b5, rook d4, a5, king b2, exchange of pawns, rook e8, king b3. It was again Damjanovich Dzyuba, Kalvet 2006, and here black should try rook e5, and with the idea rook h5, rook f5, or rook e2, it's an equal position, but I think that black's play is much easier here. And if f takes e3, then rook c4. If rook d2, then it's an equal endgame, rook b8, rook e d1, rook b5. But white made a dubious move, rook d4, rook a8, rook e d1, rook d4, rook d4, rook c4. And here already white lost some games. I won once in a blitz game. Such position, white played rook c4. It's a decisive mistake. This pawn endgame is just winning for black. D takes e4, king c2, king d5, king c3, and g5, e4, king c5, e5, h5, b4, cb, king b3, king d4, king b4, king f3, and white resigned because black is just winning here. So the other option is the move rook hd1. Then black just play the g6, rook g4, and a5, rook d4, rook hd8. Then black is just bringing the bishop to e5. For example, rook 4d3, rook ab8, bishop d4, f6, h3, bishop d6, b3, bishop e5, with the advantage for black. Bezemer, Rwanda, 2008. So the other move is rook d3, but it's just a triple position to the main line. King b1, rook hc8, and rook d3. And here black should play bishop c5, and the resulting position is drawish. Sometimes white plays rook hd1, bishop e3, f takes e3, rook c5, and the position is equal. And if rook b3, then rook a8, rook b7, rook a c7, rook c7, rook c7, rook c1, and here black should try rook c4, and the position is with small advantage for black. If white wants to do a draw, then white should try play rook c1, bishop b6, rook g1, bishop e3, and just rook e3, king f6, rook g4, rook c7, rook f4, king g6, rook g4, with the perpetual checks, Adams against Ponomarev, Sofia 2005. But rook e1 is, of course, the main continuation, bishop e3, rook d3, and now it's a very important moment. Black must play king f6, and after rook e7, the fantastic move rook c4. It's a very important idea, because now the black's rook comes to white's f and h pawns. And rook d7, and already black has to make a strong novelty. In the game Stripunsky-Dreyev, ECC 2001, it was played rook f4, but after rook d6, king f5, rook d5, king g6, rook d6, f6, white can try to do a novelty, rook d7, and after rook f3, rook g1, king a5, rook g7, rook f2, rook a7, rook a7, rook a7, rook h2, a4, the resulting endgame is just probably lost for black, because white has a dangerous passport. But after g6, black has an extra square g7 for the king. If rook d5, then just rook h4, rook h1, rook e8, rook a5, and rook e7, black will take f3 pawn, and black has a slight advantage, so rook e7 is better move, rook f8, rook a7, and here black comes for h2 pawn, it's very important, rook h4, And white should try to play a4, because if, for example, rook ed7, then h5, rook d5, and rook h2, black just promoting the h pawn with a big advantage, maybe even decisive one. So a4, white shows that the white has also a passed pawn. Rook takes a4, rook f7, rook f7, rook a4, rook b7. Black should put the rook to e2, king c1, and rook e2. So this position is an equal one. And here comes the end of this chapter. Let's make a quick conclusion. So if white doesn't want to exchange the queen, have worse pawn structure, and black just plays f6, king f7 with advantage. So white must to go to the endgame. They have, of course, some chances to get an advantage, because white has an open e-file, black has weak pawns on d5 and a7, and white also can take the c-file. But black can neutralize white's idea. They play, black play bishop b4 with protecting e1 square with the bishop, or black can transfer the bishop to e5. Also black plays rook a to d8 and then to d7 and protect both the d5 and a7 pawn. Sometimes black sacrifices a7 pawn, but taking the c line. Also, it's very important to know the black's maneuver from the main variation b, rook h8 to c8 to c4, then just attacking the h2 or f3 pawns. So this endgame is more or less drawish, and if only one side makes some mistakes, then only then one of the players can win the game. The draw is the most probable result of that endgame. So thank you for watching this video till the end. If you like the video, you can consider leaving a like, and see you next time.